song to sing to help me cope with anything. If you see the wonder of a fairy tale, you can take the future. Even if you fail, Sam Carmichael, Bill Austin, and Harry Bright. Good luck.
Guess who left her ticket on the kitchen table?
But I said we have to get on this plane. It's our best friend's wedding tomorrow. We made such a fuss. But you weren't gonna get married without your bridesmaids.
Where is he? Your Sky. We're dying to meet him.
Oh, and how's your mom? I bet Dawn is going nuts over the wedding.
Oh, listen, I've been dying for you to get here. I have a secret, and you're the only ones I can tell.
You're pregnant.
Oh, no. I invited my dad to my wedding.
Your dad?
Mm-hmm.
You mean you finally found him?
Not exactly. Look what I found in Mom's desk.
Sophie, you shouldn't go around reading your mom's diary.
No, she's supposed to go around reading yours.
Oh, but look. 1979. It's the one she kept the year she got pregnant with me. You know how she won't talk about my dad? She says she can't remember. Well, listen to this. July 17th. What a night. After the show, Sam rode me over to the little island.
Yeah, he did.
We danced on the beach and kissed on the beach and dot, dot, dot.
What?
Dot, dot, dot. That's what they did in the olden days.
No way!
Sam's the one. I know he is. I've never felt like this before. Honey, honey, how he thrills me. Uh-huh, honey, honey. Honey, honey, nearly kills me. Uh-huh, honey, honey. I've heard about him before. I wanted to know some more. And now I know what they mean. He's a love machine. Oh, he makes me dizzy. A love machine? Oh, that's nothing. Honey, honey, let me feel it. Uh-huh, honey, honey. Honey, honey, don't conceal it. Uh-huh, honey, honey. The way that you kiss goodnight.
The way that you kiss me goodnight.
The way that you hold me tight.
The way that you're holding me tight.
I feel like I wanna sing.
When you do your thing!
Is this like Sam is your dad?
The plot thickens. Sam told Mom he was going home to get married.
Pig.
Typical man.
Well, hang on. August 4th. What a night. I was still feeling depressed about Sam, but after the show, Bill rented a motorboat, so I took him over to the island. One thing led to another, and dot, dot, dot.
Bill?
Mm-hmm. August 14th. Harry turned up out of the blue, so I said I'd show him the island. I must need my head examined, but he was so sweet, I couldn't help it, and...
Dot, dot, dot!
Harry? up. The donor has a name. Three names: Sam, Bill, or Harry.
And they're all arriving for the wedding?
Yep.
Oh my gosh, Soph, do they know?
Oh, what do you write to a total stranger? Hey, come to my wedding. You might be my dad. No, they think Mom sent the invitation. And after reading what's in this diary, I'm not surprised. They all said yes! Honey, honey, touch me, baby. Honey, honey. The perfect wedding, and I want my dad there to give me away.
I hope it's a wide aisle.
Listen, we have to keep Mom out of the picture. She cannot know what I've done.
She's bound to see them sooner or later.
Well, I don't want her frightening them off, or if I ever had a chance to get to know them. With any luck, I'll know my dad straight away.
Well, what if you don't?
Then I've got 24 hours to find out. Honey, honey, how you thrill me.
Stinking stilettos.
What did you expect? A chauffeured limousine waiting at the water's edge?
Yes. Ugh. Donna knows I don't do walking.
Well, will you look at what the tide washed in?
For one night! And one night only! Donna!
How's the mother of the bride? Oh,
a lot better for seeing the two of you. Man, Tanya, 8 stinking years.
Oh, honey, I know. I'm sorry. It's just been one jet-setting millionaire after another.
Yeah, and I've been tied to this place. The constant battles with the bank manager.
Well, I pity the bank manager.
Auntie Rosie!
Oh, Sophie Sheridan, you get more gorgeous every time I see you. Well, don't I get a big fat hug? I came all this way for your wedding. Oh,
I bet you don't remember me.
All the plastic surgery.
Of course I do. Auntie Tanya.
Would you just look at my little baby, her whole life ahead of her.
Mom, I'm getting married, not joining the convent.
Oh, I know, but back in my day, you just didn't go getting married at 20.
Donna, Back in our day, we didn't get married, period.
That's a good point. What a white wedding. Can you believe it? I have no idea where she gets it from.
Don't blame me, Donna. It wasn't my idea.
Girls, meet the leading man for tomorrow's shindig. Sky, this is Tanya and Rosie, my one-time backup band and all-time best pals.
Backup band, my ass.
Hello.
Hi, nice to meet both of you. I've heard so many stories about you.
All bad, I hope.
Oh. Hey, Sky. Do you know where the hello? Yasu kuklamu passi se.
F. Caresto pulled in tifota.
Oh, don't bother. He doesn't speak Greek.
My name's Eddie. Bonjour, madame.
Bonjour, Eddie. Enchanté de faire votre connaissance.
Bon appétit!
They call me Pepper.
Why? Because you're hot?
Actually, it's because he gets up your nose.
Tanya, meet Pepper and Eddie, my boatmen, waiters, bar staff, and all-around general help. Only, generally, they're no help at all. Don't you two have some work to do?
Honey, the taverna looks fabulous.
Oh, well, we've got Sky to thank for that.
Why? What have you been up to?
You haven't been here that long, have you?
No, actually, I was in the stocks and bonds, and I left and never went back.
Why?
Well, I was traveling the world, but I wasn't living in the world.
Well, you should see what he's done to my world. He's got me online, emailed, wired up, and knuckled down.
You gotta move with the times, Donna. No more drachmas under the bed.
You just invent me a machine that'll make all the beds for me.
And if you did, you'd follow along behind them, making them again. I know you, Mom.
You've got to be kidding. I will be more than happy to put my feet up once my boat comes in.
Oh. Speaking of boats, I sink that wreck you've got moored over by the jetty.
Whoa, sink it.
It's a bit of an eyesore. Huh.
That eyesore is going to be my floating casino.
What?
Yes, Guy and Eddie, they are transforming it into a millionaire's paradise.
Just think about it. Sailing around the island, gambling under the stars.
Gambling millionaires. Maybe some of your ex-husbands will be on board, Tanya.
I don't think so, honey. I spent all their millions.
Well, girls, that's my jackpot. I need a break. I need a vacation. I have been working this hotel for 15 years and haven't had a single day off. I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay.
Oh. 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 I am glad to get off that boat.
That? Oh, that was nothing. You should try a kayak in the Okavango swamps.
Yes, I read your book. A bloke and a boat in Botswana.
Thanks, Harry. I heard I sold a copy somewhere. Well,
travel books are my passion. It's a distraction from the daily rigors of the London rush hour.
Hey, you guys want to hear something interesting? You see this taverna?
Yeah, I'm rather impressed.
I don't know.
I seem to remember an old hut here, and I was dreading bedding down with the goats.
Well, give me goats before camels. There was this time, you see, in the Kalahari, the sun was beating down, and well,
hey,
camels
hey,
spit,
sorry
you know,
to interrupt there, Indiana. But the point is, this is my taverna. I built it. Well, I designed it. I don't know. It's something I drew up like 21 years ago. I just can't believe she actually went and built it.
Who?
Donna. Who else? It's something I scribbled on the back of a menu. I had no idea.
Well, how do you know it's yours?
Oh. Buildings are like babies. You always know your own.
I wouldn't know about babies. I've been living out of a backpack my entire life.
The happy wanderer, eh? Do you think the island will inspire some prose?
I hope so. When I got the wedding invite, I sold my editor a piece entitled Childhood Haunts Revisited.
Were you born here?
Oh, no. I was born in the U.S. But my mother's Greek. No, the only time I ever came to Greece was to visit my great aunt on the mainland, and that was 21 years ago.
So now you can write about Sam's taverna and the tourists will flock.
No, I think this island needs to remain the secret ideal I've always remembered it to be.
Yes, but if you lived here, maybe the ideal would be boatloads of tourists with big bucks.
Yeah. At least they might have some staff then. I mean, where is everybody?
Oh, good afternoon. May I help you?
Hi. I'm Bill Austin. You have a room for me?
Bill Austin?
I'm Bright. Harry Bright.
Harry! So then you must be...
Sam Carmichael. You were expecting us?
yeah, sorry. I'll go get your keys now.
Charming. But I hope I get the chance to get my tongue around the little Greek language. I haven't spoken it in 21 years.
21 years? You know, guys, this is beginning to feel like a setup. Bill, here's a story for you. Three men, strangers, receive an invitation to a wedding. They receive an invite to a place they haven't been for, I don't know, 21 years, from a woman they haven't seen for 21 years. Why are they here?
That's not bad. All right, Harry, spill. What's torn you away from the Bank of England?
Is this an interview? All right. Well, for me, Donna's invitation, it brought back many happy memories and bloody Nora!
Is that a quote?
No, I know this guitar. H.B. Headbanger!
What?
That's what they used to call me in those days.
No, they did not.
Look. And D.S., Donna Sheridan, I bought this guitar for her. $10 and my Johnny Rotten t-shirt. So now who says I'm an unadventurous old stick in the mud?
Who?
My other half. A big house, a fast car, and a season ticket to the Chelsea Football Club isn't enough for some people, is it? No, they want the Great White Hunter, too. Well, I can do spontaneity. That's why I'm here. Donna knew my wild side. I was an exchange student in Paris when we met, and I just followed her to Greece, spontaneously. Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Oh, Don and I used to sing this song. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music,
for giving it to me.
You're Donna's daughter.
Uh-huh.
I thought you looked familiar. Sophie or Sophia?
It's just Sophie.
No, no, Sophia's the Greek. I had a great aunt, Sophia.
After Sophia.
Hey, where's Donna? I want to see her and thank her for the invite.
Yes, it was very kind of her to remember us.
Oh, no, you can't. You're a secret. I send the invitations. Mom doesn't know.
But why?
Oh, Mom's always talking about her friends from the olden days, and I thought she'd be thrilled if I invited you all, but she's got herself in such a state about this wedding. If you mention unexpected guests, she'll hyperventilate.
Hold on, Sophie. Are you trying to tell me that Donna didn't invite me?
Well, no, so just pretend you're here on a holiday. She'll get a lovely surprise when she sees you at my wedding, and then we can let her in on the secret.
Sophie.
Mother says I was a dancer before I could walk.
You made a big mistake.
She says I began to sing long before I could talk. And I've often wondered, how did it all start?
Lovely surprise, but the last time that I saw your mother, she said she never wanted to see me again. So if you're the one that sent invitation, I'm still banned.
Oh, but that was years ago. I want you here.
Why?
Because it's my wedding. And I want us all to be friends.
You are just a little minx. You are worse than your mother. Huh, I'm glad my boys never met you.
You have sons?
Yes, I have two, and man, I would love to bring them here someday.
Like you used to bring my mother?
What?
I've been so lucky. I am the girl with golden hair. I wanna sing it out to everybody. What a joy, what a life, what a chance.
Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music,
for giving it to me.
Would there happen to be a trouser press on the island?
I'll go check on your rooms now.
Tell me about this. So, 21 years ago. So did you put that? I think she did. No, I don't think you did. No.
Got your key?
Yep.
Donna!
Bill?
Hello, Donna!
Harry? What are...
Hi!
You!
I was cheated by you, and I think you know when. So I made up my mind, it must come to an end. Does it show again? My, my, just how much I missed ya. Yes, I've been broken hearted. This is the day we parted. Why did I ever let you go? Mama mia, now I really know. My, my, I should not have let you go. Show again, my, my, just how much I missed ya. Yes, I've been broken hearted, blue since the day we parted. Why did I ever let you go? Mama mia, now I really know. My, I should not have let you go.
Am I dreaming? Are you all really here?
Do you want me to pinch you?
You keep your hands to yourself.
You changed your tune.
What are you doing here, Sam? What are any of you doing here? I'm sorry, I'm just really amazed to see you all.
Well, I'm here to do a piece for a magazine.
Oh. And I'm here for a holiday.
Oh.
And I just thought I'd drop in and say hi.
Oh. Well, that's just too bad. You know, we're like all full up. It's that time of year. We don't have any rooms.
Well, just as well I booked ahead. And you two can bunk down with me, too, if you're really full.
This is so inconvenient.
Why?
Because one of the local girls is getting married tomorrow, and I just don't have the staff to cope with you all. You'd be very happy on the mainland.
Oh, not at all. I mean, Bill's used to suffering for his art, and well, headbanger here is the last word of spontaneous.
What about you?
You know what the island meant to me.
You know, I really love to chew over old times and all, but I've really got to go and, clean out my purse or something.
Age cannot wither her.
I was expecting a frumpy housewife.
I'll tell you what, she is still the same old Donna.
Just one look and I can hear a bell ring. One more look and I forget everything. Whoa, whoa.
right.
Heads.
Below, honey. Don't suck. All right. Let's have a look-see at what you're wearing for the wedding. Oh. You're joking.
What?
Oh, as if. Well, you could have been making some statement about the tyranny of wedlock.
You'd know more about that than me.
Oh, honey, you'll meet your Mr. Right.
Oh, I have. I did. And all he wanted to do was settle down and have babies. No thanks.
No. Children, they can be such subversive little buggers. You know, who'd have thought that Donna, the icon of female independence, would have a daughter committing matrimony at age 20?
White weddings are trendy.
What is wrong with these kids? Do you remember those t-shirts we used to wear? Marriage is an institution.
For people who belong in an institution.
Girls today seem to think that getting a man is their greatest achievement.
You've had 3 husbands.
I rest my case.
Tanya?
Oh, my lord.
Oh, my.
Oh. Oh. We were so young.
I wonder what the ladies at Whole Woman Press would think of my outfit.
Hey, we should do a number tonight at Sophie's party.
I may need to let out a few seams. Wait.
Yes, that works.
Where's Sophie?
I haven't seen her. Why?
I have to find her now.
Oh. Ta-da!
What the hell is that about?
I found it in the trunk. You should hang it in the bar. Show Sophie what a funky mom she's got.
No. Burn it. Get rid of it. I never want to see it again.
What's the matter? What happened?
I thought it was over. In the past. I'd almost forgotten, but it isn't.
What isn't?
Oh, nothing. Just leave me alone. I can't talk about it. All my life it's been tapping at my shoulder. Of course. It had to come out now. It just had to. I was such a stupid little idiot.
Chiquitita, tell me what's wrong. I have never seen such sorrow in your eyes, and the wedding is tomorrow. How I hate to see you like this.
There is no way you can deny it.
I can see
that you're oh so sad, so quiet.
Oh.
Chiquitita, tell me the truth. I'm a shoulder you can cry on. Your best friend, I'm the one you must rely on. You are always sure of yourself. Now I see you've broken a feather. I hope we can patch it up together. Chiquitita, you and I know how the heartaches come and they go and the scars they're leaving. We'll be dancing once again and the pain will end. You will have no time for grieving. Chiquitita, you and I cry, but the sun is still in the sky and shining above you. Let me hear you sing once more, like you did before. Sing a new song, Chiquitita.
Try once more, like I did before. Sing a new song. It's her dad.
Whose dad?
Sophie's. You know how I always said it was Sam the architect who went home to get married?
Pig.
Typical man.
Well, I'm not really sure it was him. There may have been just a couple others.
Donna Sheridan, you dark horse.
Why didn't you tell us? Because I didn't think I'd ever have to. I didn't think all three of them would be sitting in my bar the day before their daughter's wedding.
What?
In the bar?
Yes. Hey, don't let them see you.
Oh. I can't see anything. Who are they?
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. You think I would forget my daughter's dads? It's Sam, Bill Austin,
ooh,
and Harry Headbanger.
Oh. Not.
Turned up like this. It's like some horrible twist of fate.
It is all so very Greek.
Do they know?
Of course not. I've never told anyone. Why have they turned up to ruin Sophie's wedding?
I thought you weren't very keen on this wedding.
No, but I don't want them spoiling it. They've got no right turning up like this. What the hell have they ever done for their daughter?
Donna, be fair. They didn't know she existed.
That's right. And they don't need to know. I have done a damn good job with Sophie all by myself. And now I'm going to be muscled out by a couple of one-night stands?
No, you're not. Calm down. You'll be safe this evening. It's a male-free zone at Sophie's party, and tomorrow, Tanya and I will take them fishing.
Fishing? Oh, please.
What do you suggest we do with three men?
Now that takes me back.
Oh, I remember Bill Austin. He was a hot slice of beefcake!
Yeah, it's all a laugh and a memory to you two. But I was the one who got pregnant. I guess it just about serves me right.
Oh my God, now you sound just like your mother.
I do not!
Yes!
You do!
Oh. Whatever happened to our Donna?
the life and soul of the party. El rock chick suprema.
She grew up,
that's all.
Well, grow back down again. You haven't done anything to be ashamed of.
Yeah, screw them if they can't take a joke.
You can dance, you can jive.
What's up, Soph?
Where are you going?
Getting ready for the bachelor party, I guess. You never know with those guys. There's lap dancing at the Orpheus Bar and mud wrestling at Medusa's. And, well, Pepper's got his handcuffs, so I don't really
don't
know.
Don't go.
What? And miss out on my last night of freedom? Sure.
I don't mean don't go. I just mean... Wait. Last night of freedom? Is that how you really see this?
Well, yeah. I mean, no. No, I think of it as the last night before the best adventure of my life. Come here.
So, remember how I said I wanted to find my dad?
So, if we have been through this 1,000 times, you don't need your dad. I am here.
I know, but Sky, whatever happens, you'll never leave me, will you?
Leave you? You have turned my whole life upside down. I wasn't jealous before we met. Now every man that I see is a potential threat. And I'm possessive, it isn't nice. You've heard me saying that smoking was my only vice. But everything is new, and everything is true, and all I've learned has overturned. I beg of you,
when I don't have you near. Unsatisfied, I skip my pride. I beg you, dear,
don't go wasting your emotion. Lay all your love on me. Don't guys.
Sorry, buddy. It's an ancient island tradition. You see, the night before the wedding, the groom dives down to the old shipwreck to look for the necklace of Helen of Troy.
He who finds the pearl shall have a blessed union.
You know, back home, we usually just get drunk and black out.
Oh, we'll do that, too.
Hey, Sophie, why marry the first guy that comes along?
Pepper, I've had a few little love affairs. They didn't last very long. Pretty scarce.
I used to think that was sensible, and now the truth's even more incomprehensible.
But everything is new, and everything is new, and all I've learned has overturned. What can I do?
Sharing your devotion.
many ladies here tonight. The Summer Night Taverna is proud to present the world's first girl power band. Live before you in all its grown-up, wrinkly glory.
Speak for yourself.
Give it up, one night, one number. That's all we've got the breath for. Let's hear it for Donna and the Dynamos.
Super Trooper beams are gonna blind me, but I won't feel blue like I always do. 'Cause somewhere in the crowd there's you.
Hey!
and night, women only.
No, 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 we want the boys to stay. What? Don't we, girls?
That's all right. I'm glad you did, actually. This used to be such a quiet island.
Regretting you stayed away so long?
No, I'm just regretting I didn't know what was here.
But what?
This place, the taverna. I always meant to come back and build it someday, but that Donna, she beat me to it.
Do you always prefer buildings to people?
What?
Never mind. Tell me something about my mom.
Oh, she was irresistible. One of a kind. We laughed, we talked, we... you know, I was the one that actually brought her to this island first.
That wasn't the only thing you did, was it?
What has she told you?
Oh, nothing. She's never mentioned you before.
But you said Mom's always talking about her friends from the old days. What's going on, Sophie? Why am I here?
Is there a man out there? Someone to hear my prayer?
Donna with a grown-up daughter.
Have you got any children, Harry?
No, I haven't put myself in the path of paternity.
It's never too late.
Oh, I don't think my other half would agree.
Oh, you don't want children.
No, it's not that. I would have liked to have had a daughter. I would have spoiled her to bits.
Lucky thing.
Is your dad here?
I don't know.
What?
Well, I don't know who my dad is.
Don't know.
Is there a man out there? Someone to hear my prayer.
Whoa.
Can I be nosy? I am a writer. It goes with the territory.
Go on.
Well, how did your mom come to get this place? I mean, when I knew her, she was singing in a nightclub back on the mainland.
Oh, we were left the money in a will. We lived with an old lady when I was little. Her name was Sophia.
My great aunt, Sophia?
I think it must be.
But I was always told that her money was left with family. Wait a minute. How old are you?
20.
I needed to get a little air.
Why did your great aunt leave my mother that money?
I don't know.
You do. Please tell me.
What has your mother said?
She won't talk about the past. She doesn't understand why I need to know.
You're just gonna have to talk to her.
This has got nothing to do with her. All my life, there's been one big unanswered question. And I just don't want any more secrecy.
But Sophie, this hasn't been my secret.
I've seen you twice in a short time. Only a day since we started. It seems to me
make me talk, and you make me feel, and you make me show what I'm trying to conceal. If I trust in you, would you let me down? Would you laugh at me if I said I care for you? Could you feel
your mother tonight?
Does it mean anything to you?
Gotta trust me, I'm doing what's right, and it means a lot.
What's the name of the game? Could you feel the way I do? I wanna know. Oh yes, I wanna know. What's the name of the game? Bill, are you my father?
I think so.
Well, then you know what comes next.
Don't tell me you have a twin sister.
No. Will you give me away tomorrow?
Give you away?
I'll feel like a proper bride with my dad there to walk me down the aisle.
Sophie, the boys are back.
I'll go talk to your mom.
Wait, no, not yet. Please, let's keep this our secret until the wedding.
All right. I'll do it.
Hanging in the air, giving out a spark. Across the room, your eyes are glowing in the dark. And here we go again. We know the start, we know the end. Masters of the sea, we've done it all before, and now we're back to get some more. You know what I mean. Boulay blue, I'll take it now or leave it.
Even better.
I don't know how to tell you.
Yeah, I know I'm rushing into things, but hey, does your mother know you know?
Oh gosh, no, she can't.
No, of course not. Listen, who's giving you away?
No one?
Wrong, I am.
You?
Yeah, don't worry about Donna. She doesn't scare me. Much. Take, I'm your dad!
Harry!
Oh, the penny's dropped now. Good and proper. That's why you sent me the invitation. You want your old dad here to walk you down the aisle. Well, I'll not let you down. I'll be there!
Make a decision.
Sophie? What are you doing here? It's 6 o'clock in the morning.
I don't know.
Just wait right there.
Oh, no, Mom, I'm all right.
Of course you're not all right. You're sleepwalking again.
Again? When do I ever sleepwalk?
The night before you came down with the measles and when you couldn't finish your times tables.
Mom, get off. What? I'm not a baby.
I know you're not, Soph, but you're still my daughter. And I know when something's wrong. It isn't too late. It can be stopped. I can sort out all these wedding shenanigans.
Shenanigans? What do you mean, shenanigans?
Well, I'm sorry, it's just a phrase.
No, that's what you think, isn't it? That I'm stupid to get married. It's just a whim.
Well, I'm not pretending that I understand.
Of course you don't. You did just fine without a man, didn't you? You never did the marriage and babies thing. No, you just did the baby.
What the hell is this about? Why are you coming down on me?
I want to do it right, Mom. I love Sky and I want to be with him. And I don't want my children growing up not knowing who their father is, because it's crap.
But, Soph...
Voulez-vous, I'll take it, no leaving. Now it's all we get, nothing promised, no regret.
Will you keep it down? You're gonna wake up the whole island.
Oh, no, don't fall, I got you.
Eddie, I got where you. Did you get that monstrosity?
Oh, he's not that bad. Oh, no, you mean these.
Yes.
No, I found them in the back, in the cellar. Just what we need for a wedding. Are they yours, Donna?
No. They're... And just what sort of a wedding do you suppose it's going to be with the state of the three of you?
A good one.
Sky. Right here. You are not marrying my daughter smelling like a frat house. Or looking like one. Go hit the tub. Oh, without falling, please. And just where do you think you're going?
I'm gonna scrub the groom's back.
Oh, no, you're not. I want the champagne on ice. I want the ouzo in the punch bowls. Get out the tablecloths, the cutlery, the best glasses, and you'll have to wash and polish them first. Okay? Got it?
Yeah.
Go. Like, now? Go. Eddie. Eddie.
Yes.
Get out your boat.
Why?
Because some of the guests want to dive down to the old wreck and look for more pearl necklaces.
Wait, but I planted the necklace that Sky found last night.
I don't care. It'll keep the guests busy until the wedding starts.
Okay.
Really?
I forgot a wedding present, so I'm giving it over. Don't tell him.
Yes,
sir. Cross your heart.
Go.
Cross
your... Get the boat out.
Okay.
Go.
Okay. Bagpipes. Three.
Oh.
Bye. Oh, no, my lemon. I dropped it. Lemon drops. If all the rain drops were lemon drops and gum drops, oh, what rain.
One of us.
wishing you had never left at all. They passed me by, all of those great romances, because of your robbing me of my rightful chances. My picture clear, everything seems so easy, but then you dealt me the blow. One of us had to go. How you hurt me, I want you to know. One of us is crying, one of us is lying in a lonely bed, staring at the ceiling, wishing she were somewhere else instead. Wishing you had never left at all, never left at all.
Donna!
Oh!
Hey, hey, what's the rush?
The wedding?
Yeah, hey, about the wedding. I see you kept my bagpipes.
Oh, well, they're good to scare off unwanted visitors.
You don't need bagpipes to do that.
I wouldn't. My bite is worse than my bark.
Yeah, I know, I've got the scars. You want to see them?
What do you want, Sam?
I have an idea for an extension.
I don't want your stupid extension. Why are you here?
Because you're living my dream, remember? The taverna, the island, my dream.
It's my reality. Hard work and a crippling mortgage.
Hey, what about the roof? Let me take a look at it. It's not going to last the winter.
I'll fix my own damn roof.
Fine, be a martyr. You know, I've got kids. I know it's hard for you doing it on your own.
Don't you patronize me. I love doing it on my own. Every day I wake up, I am so thankful that I don't have some middle-aged, menopausal man to deal with. I am single, I'm free, and it's great.
Where are those happy days? They seem so hard to find. I try to reach for you, but you have closed your mind. I wish I understood. It used to be so nice, it used to be so good. So when you're near me, darling, can't you hear me? SOS. The love you gave me, nothing else could save me. SOS. When you're gone, how can I even try to go? When you're gone, though I try, how can I carry on?
You seem so far away, though you were standing near. You made me feel alive, but something died, I fear. I really tried to work it out. I wish I understood what happened to our love.
Sophie that was getting married.
That's none of your
and
business.
And this guy, is he good enough for her?
That's none of your business either.
So when you're near me, darling, can't you hear me? SOS. And the love you gave me, nothing else can save me. SOS. When you're gone, though I try, how can I care?
Here, Senora, this ought to tickle your taste buds.
Oh, yes, but will it cure my hangover?
Oh, you should look in a mirror, baby. You just cured mine.
Down, boy. I'm old enough to be your mother.
Well then, call me Oedipus.
Tanya!
Oh, Harry!
What time is it? Shouldn't you be getting ready?
Oh, don't worry about me. I've got loads of time. Besides, there's nothing worse than sitting around in your pantyhose for hours.
Well, Donna must be tearing her hair out, doing the wedding on her own. Tell me, what would the bride's father usually do?
Well, he'd usually pay. Although my dad drew the line at my third.
Well, did he say anything beforehand? Words of advice, that sort of thing.
Oh, yes. There I'd be in my cupcake dress, all ready to trip down the aisle. And he'd lean in and say, "Don't worry, doll. I know a good lawyer." Why are we talking about my dad?
Well, I think I'll go back to my room. Too much sun.
Oh, Harry. Oh, don't go.
Let's catch up tonight.
Oh.
Tanya, why don't we... catch up from last night.
I have drawn a veil over last night. Last night never happened.
Pepper, chop chop, champagne cocktails all around.
The bar's right there. Help yourself.
No, we're guests. You have to do it.
You just can't find good help these days.
No! Is that all you caught?
You should have seen the one that got away.
It was this big.
Bill, don't exaggerate. It was this big.
Drink, Bill?
Oh, no, thank you. Rosie Harris promised me the works.
I have.
You know, I keep a copy of your Whole Woman's Cookbook in my backpack.
You do? Well, then, you'll know how to pepper my snapper.
Oh, oy vey. 3 hours to blast off. Come on, girls, we've got work to do.
Work?
On my face, sweetie. A little repair and renovation.
You don't repair a masterpiece.
Oh, he's so tragic.
Just ignore him, Tanya. He can't help but be a jerk.
Well, Tanya cannot ignore the chemistry between us.
Little boys who play with fire get their fingers burned. You're so hot, teasing me. So you're blue, but I can't take a chance on a kid like you. Well, I can dance with
that you're out? Does your mother know that you're out?
Donna is going crazy. Gotta get ready for the wedding.
Sorry, Sky.
Oh, you know it's bad luck to see each other before the wedding.
Oh, it's all gone wrong anyway. Look, Sky, you gotta help me.
What's wrong?
It's a mess, and it's all my fault. I know I shouldn't have, but I read Mom's diary, and I've got 3 possible dads.
3 dads?
So I invited them to the wedding, and now all 3 think they're my dad, and they're all expecting to give me away. I'm so confused.
Go back a bit. You did what?
I invited my dads to our wedding. It was 3 months ago. I wasn't even sure they would come.
3 months?
Scott, you gotta help me.
Why didn't you tell me?
Well, because I knew you wouldn't like it.
I thought we had trust. I thought we told each other about everything, but he went behind my back for some strangers?
It wasn't like that.
You know, is this what this big wedding's for? So you can find your dad?
It's not that at all.
Oh, you know, I just want to go to the mainland and get married with a couple of witnesses. But you insisted on this big wedding so you could play happy family.
It's knowing who I am.
Here we go again.
I want to get married knowing who I am.
So if we have been through this 1,000 times, you do not need your dad to know who you are. That comes from you. How would you feel if I lied to you? I was marrying you because I loved you, and I thought that's what you wanted. I just don't know anymore.
You don't know if you love me?
I don't know if that's what you really want.
I'm interrupting. Sorry.
No, it's fine. So just let me know.
No. Sky,
hey,
wait.
Hey, no, wait,
hold on.
Wait. Let him go. No. What's going on? Listen, you got to know what you really want.
This has got nothing to do with you.
Sophie, I'm your dad. I can't give you away unless I know you're truly happy.
I've had this conversation with my mother, and she knows me a lot better than you do.
What does Donna the Dynamo know about marriage, or even divorce? Listen, I've got 21 years of good advice to cram in 2 minutes, so please, hear me out. You are so young. You've got your whole life ahead of you.
Not now, Sam.
But listen, I've been there. I've done the big white wedding and the cake, and I'm sorry to say, it doesn't always end up happy ever after. I remember pleading and pleading with my wife. No more Capri silence. Silence ever after. This empty house with tears in my eyes. This is how the story ends. This is goodbye. Knowing me, knowing you, there is nothing we can do. Knowing me, knowing you, we just have to face it this time. Breaking up is never easy, I know, but I'll have to go. Knowing me, knowing you, it's the best I can do.
So you said you have sons?
I have 2. They live with their mother. Memories, good days, bad days, they'll be with me always. In those old familiar rooms, children will play. Now there's
only emptiness, nothing to say. Knowing me, knowing you, there is nothing we can do. Knowing me, knowing you, we just have to face it this time. We're through. Breaking up is never easy, I know, but I'll have to go. Knowing me, knowing you, is the best I can do.
But that's you, not me. I love Sky more than anyone else in the world. Did you feel like that when you got married?
No.
Then it'll be all right. I know it will.
Sophie! Knowing me, knowing you, there is nothing we can do. Knowing me, knowing you, we just have to face it this time. We're through. Breaking up is never easy, I know, but I'll have to go. Knowing me, knowing you, it's the best I can do. Knowing me, knowing you, it's the best I can do.
Can't get my hat right, can't get anything right. Come in.
Donna!
Harry, what are you doing here?
I wanted to give you this.
No, not here, on the island here.
Please!
Holy crap! What's this about?
Well, I thought you must have had to tighten your belt over the years, looking after Sophie on your own, and I wanted to contribute a little something to the wedding.
This would cover 4 weddings and a funeral. It's a lovely gesture, Harry, but I just can't.
Do you remember the last time you said that to me?
No.
It was the night I bought you the guitar. I remember thinking, those are the last words I will ever hear Donna say, and I will treasure them forever. Oh, Harry, it's a lovely gesture, but...
Oh, Harry, you just made that up. I'm sure that I said thank you nicely, like a well-brought-up Catholic girl.
That's better. You know, I think that's the first time I've seen you laugh since I arrived.
What do you expect? I've been a bit stressed, Harry.
A bit more of the old Donna, and a bit less of the well-brought-up Catholic girl.
I can still recall our last summer. I still see it all. Walks along the Seine, laughing in the rain. Our last summer, memories that remain. We made our way along the river, and we sat down on the grass by the Eiffel Tower. I was so happy we had met. Oh, it was the age of no regret. Oh, yeah! Those crazy years.
years, that was the time of the flower power. But underneath, we had a fear of flying, of growing old, a fear of slowly dying. We took a chance, like we were dancing our last dance. I can still recall our last summer. I still see it all. In the tourist jam,
round the Notre Dame.
Our last summer, walking hand in hand.
Paris restaurants,
our last summer. Morning croissants,
living for the day.
Worries far away. Our last summer, we could laugh and play.
And now you're working in a bank, a family man, a football fan, and your name is Harry. How dull it seems, and yet you were the hero of my dreams.
I can still recall our last summer. I still see it all. Walks along the Seine, laughing in the rain. Our last summer, memories that remain.
Oh, hold on. Oh, Harry, I really can't take this check. I don't know why you think I should. Come in.
No, Donna, I want you to have it. But we can't talk about this now. I'll see you at the wedding.
The wedding?
I've been invited.
Oh, okay. Oh. So that's the dress. Yep. Oh, it's gorgeous. Are the girls ready to help you?
Will you help me, Mom?
Yes. School bag in hand, she leaves home in the early morning, waving goodbye with an absent-minded smile. I watch her go with a surge, that well-known sadness, and I have to sit down for a while. The feeling that I'm losing her forever, and without her laughter, that funny little girl. Slipping through my fingers all the time, I try to capture every minute, the feeling in it. Slipping through my fingers all the time, do I really see what's in her mind? Each time I think I'm close to knowing, she keeps on growing. Slipping through my fingers all the time. Hop in.
Mom?
Yes?
Do you ever feel like I'm letting you down?
Now what on earth would make you think that?
Everybody always says, your mom is so cool, running a business, home while raising a kid, and staying meanwhile all on her own.
I didn't have much choice now, did I?
What?
An unwed mom in the 70s? I couldn't very well go home. My mother disowned me.
I didn't know that.
And it's a darn good thing. I'm so glad I'm here rather than in some depressing old housing project. Look at you. You are so gorgeous.
Sleep in our eyes, her and me, at the breakfast table. Barely awake, I let precious time go by. Then when she's gone, there's that odd melancholy feeling and a sense of guilt I can't deny. What happened to those wonderful adventures? The places I had planned for us to go. Through my fingers all the time, I try to capture every minute, the feeling in it, slipping through my fingers all the time. Do I really see what's in her mind? Each time I think I'm close to knowing, she keeps on growing, slipping through my goodbye with an absent-minded smile.
Donna?
Oh, not now, Sam.
Sophie tells me that you're giving her away.
Of course. Who else?
Well, how about her dad?
He's not here.
But that's what she wants. That's what she told me. She wants her father here. Hey, and maybe that's what her father wants too.
Not now, Sam. I don't want to hear this now.
Donna! Listen. This is about us.
I don't want to talk about things we've been through, though it's hurting me. Now it's history. I've played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing left to say, no more ace to play. The winner takes it all, the loser standing small beside her. Their minds as cold as ice. To shake my hand. I apologize if it makes you feel bad seeing me so tense with no self-confidence. But you see, the winner. Until I finished.
I got this note from Sophie. She had asked me to give her away, but now she's changed her mind. I'm confused. I don't know where I am. I don't know who I am. I just came here for a wedding. I'm Sophie's dad.
Whoa. You need a conversation with Donna.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll go find her.
Whoa, 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 whoa. You'll do no such thing. Sophie's getting married in 5 minutes. Take a pew.
But I really...
And button it.
Do you even think it's okay that I'm here?
Oh, for God's sakes.
To tell you the truth, I was really beginning to dread that walk down the aisle. I mean, I may come across as the intrepid traveler, but I come over all faint at just the thought of a wedding.
Ugh, tell me about it.
Marriage, children, responsibility? No, I'm a writer. I made my mind up a long time ago. I walk a lone path.
If you change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go, if you're feeling down. If you're all alone and the pretty birds have flown, honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. Gonna do my very best, and it ain't no lie. If you put me to the test, if you let me try, take a chance on me. Take a chance on me. We could go dancing.
We could go walking.
As long as we're together. Listen to some music.
Maybe just talking.
You get to know me better. Cause you know I got so much that I wanna do. When I dream I'm alone with you, it's magic. You want me to leave it there.
Afraid of a love affair.
But I think you know that I want you. So change your mind. I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. You need me. Let me know, gonna be around. You got no place to go, you're feeling down. If you're all alone, when the pretty birds have flown, honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. Gonna do my very best, and it ain't no lie. If you put me to the test, if you let me try, take a chance on me. Oh, you can take your time, baby. I'm in no hurry. You know I'm gonna get ya. Don't wanna hurt me.
Don't worry.
I ain't gonna let ya. You know I got. Our love is strong enough to last when things get rough. It's magic. You say that I waste my time, but I can't get you off my mind.
Please be seated. Welcome. Welcome to Sophie and Skye and all their friends. Especially welcome to Donna, who represents their family. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to celebrate the wedding.
And welcome to Sophie's dad.
Oh, yeah.
What? I can't keep it from you any longer. I have to tell you. He's here.
I know.
How could... What?
I invited him.
How could you have invited him? I don't even know which one of them it is. That's why they're all here?
Oh, I am so sorry. Could you ever forgive me?
Oh, Soph, will you ever forgive me?
I don't care if you've slept with hundreds of men. You're my mom, and I love you.
Oh, Soph. I haven't slept with hundreds of men.
Hold it. Are you trying to tell me that, I don't know, that Sophie might be mine or might be Bill? Bill's or even Harry's?
That's right. And don't go getting all self-righteous with me. You've only got yourself to blame.
What?
Well, if you hadn't dumped my mom and ran off and married some other woman.
No, it wasn't like that. I had to go. I was engaged. I had to go back. It was the right thing to do. But I came back.
What?
I told Lorraine I couldn't marry her and I came right back.
Why didn't you call me?
Because I was stupid enough to think that you'd be sitting in your room pining for me. But when I arrived on the island, they said you were off with some other guy. And I went straight back home, and Lorraine told me how big an idiot I was and married me just to prove it.
Sorry, but may I cut in for a moment?
Oh, Harry, that's right, your check.
No, keep it, it's yours. Donna, you were the first girl I ever loved. And well, there's all kinds of families, aren't there? There's you and Sophie, and I think it's great just to have a third of Sophie. I never thought I'd have that much of a child.
I agree with Harry. Being one third of your dad is great by me.
Me too.
Typical, isn't it? You wait 20 years for a father and three show up at the same time.
Well, we could figure out which one of you is my dad, but I don't care. I don't need to know.
Nice.
I've learned something about myself. Skye? Let's not get married. You never wanted all this, and I've got my whole life ahead of me. Let's just get off this island and see the world.
I love you.
Donna, does this mean the wedding's canceled?
Well, I really don't have a clue what's going on.
Hey, hold on, folks. Why waste a good wedding? How about it, Sheridan? You're going to need someone to boss around this island of yours.
Are you nuts? I am not a bigamist.
Neither am I. I'm just a divorced man who has loved you for 21 years. And ever since I've been on this island, I've been bursting to tell you just how much. Come on, Donna. It's only the rest of your life.
I can't conceal it. Don't you see?
I
Even if you fail.